This is my third video on how to find the least common multiple of a list of numbers, except in this video I'm going to show you a method if you just need to find the least common multiple of two numbers. For instance, find the least common multiple of 15 and 18. Here's what we do. You just write the number 15 and 18 next to each other. You can put a comma between them if you want. And I'm going to write this thing that looks like that. It's kind of like an upside down division bar. And what we're going to do is see if we could find any factor that goes into both of those numbers. And if so, we're going to write that factor over to the left. Now, if you don't know where to start, just start with the prime numbers and see if the first prime number goes into both numbers. And if it does, you could divide by that number and then try the second number, etc. So, for instance, I could say, does 2 go into both of those numbers? No. Does 3? Yes. Or you might have just noticed 3 went into them right off the bat. So since 3 goes into both 15 and 18, you write it out in the front. So what you're going to do is write any number that goes into both of those numbers out front to the left, and then you're going to divide. It's sort of like I'm doing an upside down division, and the reason is because that way I'll be able to go down the paper and not run off the top of your page. So 3 goes into 15 5 times, and 3 goes into 18 6 times. Now, you look at your two numbers that you got, and 5 and 6 in this case, and you see if there's any other numbers that go into both 5 and 6. I'll give you a little hint. Anytime you have two consecutive numbers, like 5 and 6, 8 and 9, 21 and 22, two consecutive numbers, there's never any number except one that goes into both of those. I'm not going to tell you why, because that's kind of a hard problem, but it is something that happens to be true. All right, so nothing goes into 5 and 6 except one. That's when you stop, and here's how you get the least common multiple. This is very, very cool. You multiply the numbers that are catty-cornered from each other. So 15 times 6. Now, 15 times 6 is what? 90. Or you can multiply the other two numbers. 5 times 18 is also 90. It doesn't matter which way you do it, so do whatever's easiest for you. Either 15 times 6 or 18 times 5. Or you could take all the numbers on the outside and multiply them by each other. So for instance, I could multiply these three numbers times themselves, 3 times 5 times 6. So you might think of 6 times 5 is 30, and 30 times 3 is also 90. So you've got three ways to get the answer. Let's do another one. Find the LCM of 24 and 30. All right, so we put 24 and 30. Under the bar. And we think of any number that goes into 24 and 30. I'm going to move this over because I'm going to do this more than one way. All right, so here we go. Any number that goes into 24 and 30. All right, so maybe someone says, oh, 2 goes into it. That's fine. You could divide by 2. 2 goes into 24 12 times, and 2 goes into 30 15 times. And now you have to look again. Is there any number that goes into both 12 and 15? And 3 goes into both numbers. Remember, if you're not sure, just go through the prime numbers. Does 2 go into both numbers? Does 3 go into both numbers? And yes, 3 does. So 3 goes into both numbers. 3 goes into 12 4 times, and 3 goes into 15 5 times. Oh, and here's another example where they're consecutive, 4 and 5, so that's going to be the end of it. There's no other number except one that goes into 4 and 5. So here's how it works. You take the numbers catty corner, you could either do 24 times 5, or you could do 30 times 4. Now, which is easier? I think 30 times 4, the answer is 120. That's the least common multiple. But if you did 24 times 5, you would also get 120. Or if you multiplied all these numbers on the outside, so 2 times 3 times 4, times 5, if you multiplied all those numbers together, you would also get 120. Now let's do the same problem again, putting 24 and 30 using this little bar. And what you really want to do if possible is think of the biggest number that goes into both of those. Of course, what I'm talking about is the greatest common factor, the largest factor that goes into both numbers. And that would be 6. 6 goes into both of these numbers. If I divide it by 6, 6 goes into 24 4 times, and 6 goes into 35 times. And you still are going to multiply the same numbers together, either 25 times 4 or 30 times I'm sorry, 24 times 5 or 30 times 4, again, you're going to get 120. So if you don't pick the biggest number, like I started off with dividing both by 2, as long as I keep going, you still work to do the catty corner, the uppermost left with the lowermost right, or the vice versa, and you're going to get 120. Or, of course, multiply along the side here. 6 times 4 times 5. All right, let's do another one. Do you like this method? I think it's really neat. All right, find the LCM of 35 and 63. So we put 35 and 63, and we're going to try to think of any number that goes into both of those. Now, I see a number in my mind, but if you don't, go through the prime numbers. Does 2 go into both numbers? No. Does 3? No. Does 5? No. Does 7? Yes. 7 goes into both of those numbers from your times tables. So 7 into 35 is 5, and 7 into 63 is 9. And then you're going to have to multiply either 35 times 9 or 63 times 5, or you could do 7 times 5 times 9. You could use your calculator, and whatever you get the same answer as me, which is 315. So 315 is the least common multiple of 35 and 63. Now, one other thing that's pretty cool about this method is you know what you'd have to multiply each number by to get that 315. That's going to be very useful when we're adding fractions. In fact, that's why we want to know what the least common multiple of a number is. It's going to be useful when we have to add fractions. So it tells you that 35 times 9 gives you 315, or 63 times 5 gives you 315. All right, how about another one? All right, why don't you try this one? Find the least common multiple of 18 and 42. So let's see, more than one way to do this. You try to think of the biggest number that goes into both of them, and that is 6. 6 goes into both of those numbers from your times tables. 6 into 18 is 3, and 6 into 42 is 7. So you need to multiply either 18 times 7, 42 times 3, or 6 times 3 times 7. And let's see, to me it looks like the 3 times 42 is easiest. That's 126. Now, if you didn't think of 6, remember, you could pick a smaller number that goes into each of them. 2. 2 goes into 18 9 times. Since they're both even, I knew 2 went into them. And 2 into 42 is 21. And then I have to think of a number that goes into both 9 and 21. And 2 doesn't go into both of them, but 3 does. So I could divide by 3. And notice I'll get the same thing, either 18 times 7 or 42 times 3. All right, so this is a method if you want to find it between two numbers. Could you use this for more than two numbers? You could, but it would take two steps. So let's just do one problem like that. So here's an example. Find the least common multiple of 9, 12, and 15. Well, first you're going to have to find it between two numbers. So let's start off with 9 and 12. 3 goes into both of those numbers. And so the least common multiple, you could either think of it as 9 times 4 or 12 times 3. So we've got 36 so far here. And now you have to find it between 36 and 15. All right, so then you do it again. 36, 15. And you think, what number goes into both 36 and 15? Well, 3. 3 goes into 36 12 times, and 3 goes into 15 5 times, and then you could multiply either way, you're going to get 180. So the answer to this problem is 180, but it took two iterations. Now, it's easier probably to use that other method I showed you, the building up one, where you say, well, you've got 9, 12, and 15, and we just use prime factorization, starting with 9 is 3 times 3, and then 12 is 2 times 2 times 3. So it has the 3, I need two 2s for that 9, and then 15 is 3 times 5, so you've got the 3, you need the 5 in, and you should get exactly the same answer. That also is going to be 180. So there are a couple ways to get the least common multiple. of three numbers. So this is especially useful for two numbers, though. It's a pretty quick and easy way, and it'll be helpful when we are adding or subtracting fractions as well.